So where focuses on two different elements. Where do you want to serve? Those are the cities in which you want to do business in. So as your business grows, I kind of want to use more heart, but I understand. So as you guys are choosing these different cities, remember your business can scale in depth and width. So depth is you can scale the total number of services that you want to target. Width is the total number of areas in which you want to market those individual services that can expand. So let's say 100% of the services you have on your website are already on page one of Google in these cities. If you want to expand, add more locations. Or if you're already on page one of Google and all the locations you're willing to drive to, and I ain't driving outside of this area, then you need to expand the number of services that you're going after. So you need to add something like plumbing, add something like installing Tesla charging stations, add something like installing security systems, add something like electrical, add something like installing fireplaces, there's plenty of other services that you can continue to add. If you max out or cap out your revenue for whatever combination of services you want to sell and cities you want to sell it, then identify another service you want to sell or another marketplace in which you want to market. The second piece to where is, where are those consumers searching? They are searching online. They are asking Google Home or Alexa or Bixby or whatever little talking head that they have or device in their home and office space. They are asking their friends on social media. They are searching on Facebook. They are searching on Google Maps. They are asking their phone for an answer, which produces local maps results as the options, not local search results as the options. So where are they searching? And then create a strategy for that.
Yellow pages.
Yes. You might have areas in the United States where they're not using yellow pages as a doorstop or a child seat or a fire starter. Yes.
Those you named all the other ones.
Those places exist somewhere, right? So they are looking on YouTube. They are handymen. Knowing your audience matters. If they're a handyman and believe they can fix it themselves, they're going to YouTube and they're saying, how do I fix my air conditioner? In fact, one of those guys is sitting on this call. I watched him rip his whole air conditioning system apart. And the other one's also on this call who produces the videos and the how-tos of how to fix this stuff on their own. So here's the trick, right? Make the video complicated and then they'll call you and ask you to come fix it after they break it.
That's a great strategy. And it happens to go with knowing your audience and knowing what they're afraid of and knowing your audience that's confident and how to provide them with enough confidence to make sure they don't know what they don't know. And now they do. And now they want to contact you, you know. It all depends on your strategy and your brand personality, but everyone's definitely unique and different.